Right, Aki Kareem for British Boxers. We're here at Phoenix Camp today, Robert Rimmer's Phoenix Camp, and we've got unbeaten Kane Gardner with us. Kane, good to see you, mate.
Good to see you soon, mate.
Good sparring session there with Adam Haig. You're looking fit and strong on there in the lead up to Saturday's fight.
Yeah, that's what I mean, boxing Saturday. Don't normally spar this close to fight, but I just like to get a bit like sharpen up the 6 good rounds in. I'm ready to go now.
Now you're 5-0 at the minute. Two of your last three have come by way of stoppage, though.
No. Yeah, two of my last three. So I'm looking to carry it on and obviously put on another dominant performance on Saturday night.
You actually made your name obviously in the amateurs with your eye-catching style.
Yeah.
But you've carried that through to the pros and a lot of people are talking about you. Are you aware of that sort of side of things?
In fact, the commentator's been saying it. And the people around me have been saying that I've been coming on leaps and bounds since I turned over. Yeah, and when I was an amateur, I was training as a pro anyway in the mornings and that. So I just carried it on, really. Yeah.
Have you sort of enjoyed sort of the pro ranks and the differences in the,
oh, yeah,
in the trainers? What do you like more about the training as a professional than as an amateur?
It's hard. I like hard work. So I love the grinding every morning, getting up, running late at night. I just love it. And the people around me, yeah.
Now, this fight on Saturday, it's been, yeah. I think it's been made at, I think it's 10-5 or
10-5. 10-5, yeah.
But you can make 10 stone, can't you?
Yeah, I was 10-1 in my last fight. I was 10-1 and I made that comfortable. So yeah, I made 10 stone, but I had to change an opponent. I was meant to box Fons Alexander, but he got stopped the other week. So then he got me another opponent, it's a bit heavier, the welter. So he's looking at 10-5, so I can come at 10-5. Yeah, first 6 rounder as well.
Now, obviously, tell us a little bit about sort of your influences in you know, the boxers that influence you, because your style, you know, you switch, you're fast, you know, you're agile, you're creative. I mean,
I've done that since I was a kid, since I first started when I was 9, just switching and getting round people. I don't really watch many fighters, to be honest. I watch obviously like the fights on the weekend, like just watch the Khan one. But I don't really like study people. I just myself really. Comes like natural, what's natural.
Fair play. Now, it's the first 6 rounder as well, isn't it?
Yeah, first 6 rounder.
So, are you looking forward to that step up?
Oh, looking forward to it. I meant to do a 6 rounder in my last fight, but again, kid pulled out literally a week before. So, then they got me a kid there, but he didn't want to go 6 because he come from Belfast. He didn't want to do 6, so. But I got him out of there in 3 anyway.
Yeah. You got him out of there.
Hopefully, this one goes to plan. And I can get in the first 6 rounder, but I'm not looking to go the distance.
That's the thing with you, isn't it? You actively look to taking people out, don't you?
So you don't get paid for overtime, yeah. So I see it, so I'm trying to get in there and put on a dominant.
What do you say to the people that say, well, you need to get some rounds in the bank, you know, under the lights? What do you say to those sort of comments?
I spar literally all the time anyway, getting the rounds. I know it's different to fighting, but it's not that different. I spar with 8 rounds, 10 rounds, so. Yeah. So it doesn't really matter.
Tell us a little bit about you know, where you're training. Tell us a little bit about the setup there.
Yeah, well, it's an amateur gym. It's my own amateur gym. So I train with the amateurs at the night time just to keep me in. You know what I mean? I'm a coach as well, so I coach the kids and take them out fighting. Yeah, I'm learning a lot as a coach as well, so I'm bringing both aspects of the game. So yeah.
So you know, with your coaching as well,
yeah.
I mean, is that something that you help to sort of almost refine your own technique, you know, when you're teaching people
I'm showing the kids how to do it. I mean, I've got to show the kids how to do it right. I got to show the kids how to do it right, and then you get in the ring and do it wrong, if you know what I mean.
Yeah.
So yeah, that's what I show the kids what to do, and then so put it into practice myself.
By all the sounds of it though, you're coming out all guns blazing on Saturday.
Yeah, I'm ready to go now. Actually biting at the bit, I'm ready to go, I can't wait. It's going to be a good build, a lot of good kids on it. Yeah, I just can't wait.
Alright, cool. Well, I mean, that show's got a lot of, because it's the first sort of kickoff season.
Yeah.
Got a lot of good talent on it.
Yeah,
so you have to do something special to steal the show.
That's what I mean. We'll get fired tonight, I've got to do something. Because I know obviously Lyndon's on it, he's probably going to stop the kid. And Danny Wright, he's comes forward, boom, 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 so he'll probably do something. So I've got to do the same.
Is Steve offering a bonus for a fighter of the night?
If he was, I'd be like, I hope he is.
You know what, I'm going to suggest it to him.
Isn't it?
You know,
should.
A lot of shows you go to, they have a little bonus.
Did
they? Yeah. I've just cost Steve $1,000 there, but... all right, man. Any sort of final shout-outs and words to people that are going to be coming out to support you on Saturday?
Yeah, I sort of thank my supporters there for the continued support. Just over a year now as a pro, a lot of people have been following me and coming to my fight, so I sort of thank them. And then the sponsors, that's been backing me since the start. Can't thank them enough for sorting me out. Because obviously I don't work, so they're funding me, my training and my food and that. I just can't thank them enough, to be honest. Yeah.
Perfect, man. Well, listen, looking forward to seeing you Saturday. I'll be there to watch it, and looking forward to seeing you in action as always.
Thank you, okay.
Cheers, man. Appreciate it. Awa.